Welcome to the Zeroth Tartarus Devlog. In this video, I'll cover the Tartarus project's background and trajectory and discuss a few of the core features I'm planning to implement. Lastly, I'll share a few exciting ways I'd like to apply the engine in the not-too-distant future. Tartarus is a C++ game engine I'm developing mostly from scratch. By that, I mean that I'm developing the bulk of the game-related functionality, but defer to external libraries for tasks that are platform-specific and possibly tedious or pedantic, like window handling, text rendering, and so forth. Throughout this series, you'll get to see Tartarus evolve as I add new features and improve its functionality and flexibility. In fact, Tartarus has had a couple previous incarnations, but this time's a little different for two primary reasons. First, I'm following what's called a test-driven development or TDD style of programming, in which the software is constructed to fulfill requirements specified by what are called unit tests. A good analogy: if you're building a bridge, you draft blueprints. Then, you build the bridge to the blueprint specification. Unit tests are to software as blueprints are to construction sites. Unfortunately, I used to write code by just clacking away without explicitly designing the purpose or function. I was programming. In this iteration, I'm being much more intentional with my design and treating Tartarus like a piece of software rather than a piece of code. I'm now developing. Among other things, TDD helps improve code reliability and dramatically reduces the risk of introducing bugs when refactoring code. It doesn't even come close to making Tartarus bulletproof, but it does act as a metaphorical Kevlar vest. Secondly, and more importantly, I'm writing Tartarus using the data-oriented design or DOD paradigm. I'll probably get into the weeds in another video, but a simple analogy will suffice for now. Imagine an Excel spreadsheet of YouTube users in which each row corresponds to a unique user. Each column is a different feature of that user, such as email address, username, and so forth. Previous versions of Tartarus used to process data by iterating over each row, that is, each user. Although there's no well-defined way that DOD style of programming has to function, Tartarus leverages it by instead iterating over each column or each feature. Intuitively, this may seem more complicated, and perhaps in some ways it is, but along with potentially massive speed improvements and simpler paths to parallelization, the latter approach theoretically affords significantly more flexibility, as we'll see in future videos. Now, some watching may question why I'm developing a game engine at all. Why not use Unity or Unreal Engine or any one of the myriad of options available? Simply put, I have a passion for tackling extremely challenging problems, enjoy expressing my creativity in code, and like the idea of being able to customize every aspect of my own piece of software. But even if these points resonate with you, you might wince a little when asking, but why C++? Admittedly, it's a monstrously verbose and needlessly complex language. Some might say it should be left in the 90s where it belongs, but what I enjoy about C++ is that it offers very fine control over nearly any detail of how a program functions. Certainly, good C++ has to be written with a level of rigor that many modern and higher level languages scoff at, but for me, that encourages a better understanding of what the code is doing and how it can be improved. Obviously, every language has its merits, but there's a reason why C++ is used so broadly in high performance applications like video games. There are a couple additional important points that I want to touch on before proceeding. Often, creators provide walkthroughs and tutorials showing users how to implement and code the features they discuss. At least tentatively, I won't be providing any tutorials regarding the content shown in this series. These devlogs are strictly intended to provide updates on how the software is progressing. Secondly, creators often share the source code so that viewers can comb through and reuse it, but I have no plans to release the source code because I don't yet know how I might use it in the future. If you're interested in getting your hands on Game Engine source code, there are plenty of open source projects you can find, use, and learn from. With all that said, let's get into my aspirations for this project. Although it's a preliminary list, I have several ideas for features I want to add to the engine. First off, I'm planning to implement standard GUI elements like text rendering, object picking, and so forth. That'll make it really easy to create things like heads-up displays and options menus. Eventually, I'll also implement sophisticated rigid body physics, including collision detection and constraints. This will allow dynamic and responsive game environments with which the user can interact. I also intend to add tools for performing real-time data analysis. This capability would allow the plotting, modeling, and prediction of in-game quantities like velocity or population size, and deliver real-time insights while the game's being played. Lastly, I'll be implementing non-trivial AI that'll allow me to create non-human entities who can interact with the player and environment and further contribute to a dynamic game world. With a well-designed game engine, it should be possible to build and explore some pretty fascinating environments and problems. If I can manage to implement even just a few of these features, then I've already thought of several interesting ways I'd like to apply them. Without getting into the specifics so as not to spoil these ideas, I'm really interested in doing some epidemiological simulations. Think of the game Pandemic 2. Also, I'm envisioning gravitational or electrodynamic simulations. For instance, how might a planet orbit three stars? There are a few thermodynamic problems I'm also excited to continue exploring, including percolation theory, which is a type of network analysis problem, and the Ising model. Lastly, I have a few game ideas, one of which involves launching projectiles and dodging your opponents. I'll quickly point out the irony that applying the game engine to make a game is the last on my list of applications. Obviously, I can't implement all these ideas at once, but I'm looking forward to exploring this catalog. Hopefully, you'll join me on that exciting journey. Thanks for sticking around. I realize this video wasn't the most exciting, but stay tuned. As I build out Tartarus, these videos will become richer with more dynamic and visual material. If you enjoyed this content, I'd appreciate a like and your subscription if you want to stay up to date on this Devlog series. Although I have tons of exciting material planned for Tartarus, I'm always open to new ideas and suggestions. Leave me a comment on what features or content you'd like to see in a future Devlog video. Until next time, remember to build others up instead of tearing them down.